Long ago, a young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father, who was hard at work. But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence, the bushes empty. Yet determined to find the berries, the rascal broke free from Mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine and under branch, and into the forest deep. Feeling strange eyes upon her, the girl recalled Mother's scary bedtime tales, and her throat became bone dry. Then the Bat Lord appeared. He greeted her warmly and bit his own wing. "Come, child, quench your thirst," he said. So she drank the thick, dark blood and smiled with joy. Passing through the graveyard, menacing storm clouds loomed, and the air turned bitingly cold. The girl was shivering in her thin clothes. Then a dark weaver appeared, and with a clip of his fingers, crafted mist into a beautiful dress. "Come, child, warm yourself," he coaxed. So she clothed herself and smiled with joy. Across waters deep and ominous she went, hoping a boat she found would carry her home. But hunger's grip tightened and her heart grew heavy. Then the Fish King appeared and offered one of his many fins. "Come, child, eat your fill." So the girl ate and smiled with joy once more. Continuing on, she soon entered the forest's dark heart. Then an iron steed appeared, bearing a beautiful golden gear. The creature said nothing as the girl approached and snatched what she thought was another gift. The horse grew angry and summoned the other monsters. Terror filled the girl's heart as the wild wind rose around the beasts. Suddenly, a witch appeared, dark yet regal. "Gifts we gave, but more you took," she snarled. "So more in turn is due." In a blink, the girl was trapped inside a mirror. There. She's asleep.
What is with the creepy story? She's only 6 months old.
Woman at the store said it was traditional. A local tale. Besides, Rose doesn't seem to mind.
Because she doesn't understand it, thank God. We moved here so that she wouldn't have to deal with any of that, remember?
There's nothing wrong with my memory.
You're just being paranoid.
It's not... Never mind. I'm sorry. But I'm not paranoid. I'm just cautious.
Then, go cautiously take your daughter to bed. I'll finish dinner.
It's okay, Rose. Your mother doesn't want to remember it. I can't blame her.
Did you say something?
Nothing. I'll put her down.
They're there. It's like I said to your mom. That book's too scary for you. Almost there, honey. There you go, sweetheart. Don't you worry. I'll be right downstairs. Daddy won't let those weird fairy tale monsters get you.
Is she okay?
Sleeping like a baby. That smells good. What's that?
Oh, hands off, mister. It's churba de legum. It's a local recipe.
Wow, you've gone full native, haven't you?
Local wine, too. But if you're gonna keep sulking all evening, maybe you shouldn't have any. You really have to stop worrying.
It's just finding you in Louisiana, the pregnancy, Chris moving us here, military training, it all happened so fast, you know?
Well, at least we're all together. You, me, Rose. Now, everything's gonna
Seriously, think we can just forget about what happened in Louisiana?
It happened so long ago. I don't understand why you are so...
Mia! Get down! Mia! Oh, God. Chris? What the hell?
Sorry, Ethan.
No! What? Why?
Go move!
All clear.
Rose?
What the hell are you doing with my daughter?
Package secure, sir.
Take him away.
I said get your hands off her!
Ethan, no.
Hey, Doc.
Hello, Mr. Winters. I've got your daughter's results back, and I'd like you to come in to talk about that. How about next Thursday, 4 o'clock?
No problem. We'll be there. That was the Doc. She'll see us next week.
Hey, now. Think positively, all right? We talked about this.
I know. We hardly talk about anything else. Keep telling you, it's not Rose that I'm worried about.
Well, then what are you worried about? Look, she's gonna be fine. I just know it. What else matters?
We matter, Ethan! You matter! You just
Mia, what are you talking about? Is there something you're not telling me? Come on, talk to me.
Damn it. I have to take this.
Jesus.
About damn time. What's your status? Is the package safe?
What are you talking about? Where's Chris Redfield? And Rose?
Who is this? This is a secure channel. You are not authorized to walk over.
What the hell happened here? Thank you. What did all this? Where the hell am I? What happened?
No, no! Friendly! Friendly! Who are you? Who sent you?
Nobody. There was an accident down on the road and... What's going on?
Oh, no. They're coming.
Who is? What the hell was that?
Do you have a gun?
What?
Please tell me you have a gun.
No, why would I?
Take it! Take it! Dead body? Wait, there's more. Jesus Christ. What the hell is wrong with this place? What the hell?
damn it.
There's no end to them.
Thank you.
way.
Wait.
In life and in death, we give glory.
Hello? You shouldn't be out here. It's not safe. What the hell? Hey, can you hear me?
It's you, the child's father.
Child? Hey, wait, do you mean Rose? Is she here?
Rose! Rose, yes. She is in great danger. Since Mother Miranda brought her to the village, we have fallen into darkness.
What are you talking about? The monsters?
The castle bell heralds danger. They're coming!
No. Wait. Where's Rose? Who's Mother Miranda?
The bell tolls for us all. They're coming again!
Rose is here? What are you doing here?
Stay back.
Please, don't hurt us.
Whoa. It's okay. I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just glad to see normal people at last. Have you seen any other survivors?
No. They're all in Louise's house. And she's not answering and the gate is locked.
Quiet, girl. He's an outsider.
We're sitting ducks in here. Can your old man walk?
No. One of the monsters cut him. He's lost a lot of blood. We have to get into Louise's house.
Shh! Quiet! Must be a way inside. Stay here. Be quiet. And don't move until I get those gates open.
Huh?
Come on, it's clear.
Hurry, hurry!
Took your damn time. Oh,
you're welcome.
He's not used to relying on other people. I'm sorry. We'll be safe in here, won't we?
Safer here than out there, that's for sure. Hey, do you know anything about what's going on around here?
It doesn't make any sense. Mother Miranda has always protected us.
Nobody's answer.
Father? We have to get inside.
Hello? Anybody home?
Maybe a familiar voice. Louisa! Open up! It's me, Elena!
Stop shouting. You'll draw the monsters.
Julian, calm down.
Who's this?
A friend.
Stay back.
Father, for God's sake, Julian, let us in.
No, they'll smell the blood. You'll endanger us all.
My father will die out here.
That's not my problem.
What's going on?
These people want to let a dying man into our home.
Come now. These people are our friends. Go on. Go inside. Come now. This way. You're not from this village.
No. I'm Ethan.
Julian, go make yourself useful and check the grounds. I said go! Well, if Elena trusts you, then so do I. Come inside, Ethan. Wait here. I'll check on the others. This way. Come inside, the others are waiting.
What the fuck is this? Outsiders, you're gonna get us all killed!
Christ, Anton! He helped Leonardo and Elena.
We were doing fine by ourselves.
Please, Ethan, take a seat.
Is this all that's left? From your entire village?
All that's left? All that's left? There is no one left! A worthless invalid! A stupid, wailing bitch! And you! You drag a bloody man and an outsider in here like it's nothing? And expect to be all safe? There is no safe! Every sorry bastard out there has been ripped in half. But tomorrow? Tomorrow we'll all be dead. Just like her damn husband. Put a sock in it, Roxanna!
That's enough! This house has protected my family for generations. And drunk or not, you are all welcome and safe in here.
Whatever.
Can someone please tell me what the hell is going on here?
We don't know. One day we were a quiet, devout village, and the next, the monsters came and attacked us. And they kept coming.
Wait, Louisa, where is your husband? Did they?
No. No, he is out there. Somewhere. He went to get help. Yes, that's it. He went to fetch help.
Let us pray. For him. For all of us.
Good idea. Come. Gather.
Great ones, hear our voice. Together as one in reverence, we call on thee. Within the endless dark, to deliver us into fate's hands. As the midnight moon rises on black wings, so we make our sacrifice and await the light at the end. In life and in death, we give you glory, Mother Miranda.
Now, the tea should be ready. Come help me, Elena, please.
That prayer, I've heard it before. There was an old woman near the graveyard.
You mean a hag? Some bitch is crazy as a bag of rats.
There is wisdom in her devotion, though. And I hope it protected her as it shall protect us.
What are you doing?
Leonardo, what's wrong? Are you okay?
You did the right thing. Elena! Elena, no! There's nothing you can do!
Papa!
This entire place is collapsing!
No!
You couldn't save him. He was already gone.
Leave me alone!
No. We're getting out of here. Together. I gotta get out of here. Damn, the fire's moving fast.
Back. We can bust out with this.
Let me back up again.
The fire! There isn't any time!
Nowhere to go but up. Grab on. Hurry. Let's move. Don't worry. And try not to breathe in the smoke.
I know. Thank you, Ethan. Kind.
Come on, it'll hold. There, that's our way out.
Thank God. But what then? The village is still full of monsters. We can't fight them, there's too many.
Hey, don't talk like that. We'll find a safe house to put you in until I can find my daughter. My hunch is she's in that old castle.
No. That place is full of nothing but blood and death. And I don't want to be alone while you're... Father?
Elena, no. That's not him. Not anymore.
He said my name. Father!
Wait,
Jane, it's not safe! Stay there! Come on! Give me your hand!
Ethan, go! Save your daughter!
Elena, don't give up! Reach for me! God damn it! Why is everyone dying on me? This is just too much. I just don't get it. This place is going mad. Why the fuck is this happening again? Shit! This leads to the castle. Nothing but blood and death.
Anyone was left. You must be pretty tough, huh?
Who the fuck are you?
Oh, you're not local. Even better. Mother Miranda is gonna love you. You're whining. We're almost there.
The man is of no real use to anyone else, and my daughters do so love entertaining fools. Furthermore, I can show that you entrust the moral to have some trust. My daughters and I will live
with you. Ugly, I want to see. He's awake!
Brother, shut the fuck up!
What? Where?
You mean you'll screw around with him in private? Where's the fun in that? Give him to me, and I'll put on a show that everybody can enjoy.
Oh, so gauche. What do we care for bread and circuses? The man thinks suffering is assured.
Yak, yak, if a man's dick is cut off in the castle, blah, blah, blah.
I've heard all your arguments.
Some of you were less persuasive than others, but I've made my decision. Heisenberg, the man's fate is in your hands.
Mother Miranda, I must protest. Heisenberg is but a child, and his devotion to you is questionable. Give the mortal to me, and I will ensure he is ready.
Shut your damn mouth! And don't be a sore loser! You'll find your food somewhere else.
Quiet now, child. Adults are talking.
I'm the child. You're the one who's arguing with Miranda's decision.
You wouldn't know responsibility if it was welded
oh,
to
oh, keep glory! One day your head might actually fit your ego!
Fight! Hey, don't I get a say in this?
Silence!
My decision is final. There will be no more fight. Remember from whence you came.
Thank you. Lycans and gentlemen, we thank you for waiting. And now let the games begin.
Let's see what you have here. Ethan Winters.
Get ready.
No way!
Ten. Nine.
Jesus Christ!
That's right. Run for your life. Very nice, Ethan.
Those freaks have Rose?
I've been waiting for you, Mr. Winters.
How do you know my name?
Anyone who is anyone has heard of the likes of you. A hero searching for his daughter. Though I must say, that castle arouses suspicion.
Yeah, and so do you.
I am but a humble merchant.
Here?
Oh, forgive my manners. Call me the Duke. Now to business. weapons, ammunition, healing salves, anything you desire, I can provide.